Hello students, in chapter 4 of your NCERT science book, we are going to talk about the topic sorting materials into groups. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Prakash Trivedi and I am here because I love to educate, and you can also follow me on Everyone Loves Prakash on Facebook. Moving on, if you talk about the introduction of this chapter, so in this chapter 4, which is sorting materials into groups, we would be talking about different types of classification of items into different groups. So in this chapter we will be discussing what is the basis of classification, the importance of it, and also the need of different groups. Why do we require multiple groups? Though we also need to remember that one object could be part of multiple groups, so we need to be very open-minded. So you have to observe very keenly during the entire session. The first thing we are going to talk about is classification. So what is classification? If we talk about the meaning of classification, the process of sorting things on some basis and grouping them is called classification. So classification is required to identify things easily, locate them without delay, and study their properties conveniently. An example would be if you are looking for medicine in your house, and if you have a first aid box, the first place you're going to look for is the first aid box. Other examples could be a red car, a blue flower, or a brown cow. So here we are taking the color as a classification method. Next, if we talk about what is the criteria for classification, so different items are classified on different basis to ensure that their properties match. So there should be one similarity between two products. Okay, for example, a brown bottle and a green bottle. Okay. If they are both made of plastic, okay, so obviously from colors perspective they will not match because one is brown, one is green, but because they are made of plastic they will fall in the same group. So the property here is the plastic. Okay, so few classification criteria we are going to discuss here is listed in this table. If you see this table, and this is the table that we are going to follow, this is a table that you need to understand and remember. Okay, the first one is color. So we have examples as green leaves, green glass, and green board. We have size and shape, which means pizza, chessboard, table, balloons. So they have different sizes. Okay, then we are talking about material. So glass, steel, plastic, copper, these are different types of material. Texture, rock, grass, skin. Density, light feather and iron. Transparency, glass, wood, plastic bottle. Magnetic property, iron, steel, aluminium. Electrical conductivity, metal wire, wooden handle, rubber slippers. Solubility, sugar water solution, oil water solution, and sand water solution. Luster, diamond, gold, wood. Living or non-living, cat, rat, chair, table. So these are the groups on the basis of properties. Now we are going to talk about each and every one of them in detail. The first one is color. So let's start with color. So color is a characteristic of visual categories. Okay, so for example, when you see something, okay, you know exactly what is the color of that particular object. So when you see the school bus, you know it's yellow. When you see the school building, you know it's yellow. When you see the trees, you see they are green. So this is how we classify basis visual category. Okay, so you are able to see and you are able to tell. Next one is shape and size. So shape and size of different products can be ascertained with the help of visual aid and touch. So you can see exactly what is the size or the what is the shape of that particular thing. At the same time, okay, you can also touch them and you can tell whether this item is square, whether this item is circle. Okay, so when you see a globe, we know it's circular. Okay, so when you see the globe, even if you feel it, okay, if you use your hands to touch it, okay, you know that it is in a circular form. Next up, we have material. A material is a substance or mixture of substance that constitutes an object. So a couple of items could be brought together to make one particular thing. Material talks about making products of the item. An item could be made of glass, plastic, steel. Okay, so it could be anything. So for example, it could be a glass. So if you see the three diagrams which are there, okay, one is a glass, one is a steel glass, one is a plastic glass, but what is the one thing which is common? They are all glasses. Okay, so if you want to drink water, you have to require any of these. Next up, we have texture. So texture is when you touch something, okay? So texture is the feel, appearance or consistency of the substance or surface. So based on the material, the texture could be rough or smooth. The best example is neem tree and neem leaves, okay? So in one tree, you will find if you touch the bark of it, okay, it will be very rough. But if you touch the leaves, even if you touch the seeds of neem tree, okay, you will find it is very smooth, okay? So the bark is very rough and the tree leaves are very smooth. So that is texture. Next up, we have density. Density is a bit different than the actual weight, okay? So the property due to which the materials can be classified as light or heavy is called density. So density can be defined as mass per unit volume. So the formula is density equal to mass divided by volume. Now if we see, we have 2 kg watt here and we also have 2 kg of wool here. Okay, so if we talk about density, the density of the iron, okay, which is the watt, will be heavier, okay, than the wool because of the structure of it, okay, because the structure of the wool is very light. Okay, moving on, if we talk about transparency is of 3 types, which we would be discussing in future chapters also. So the first one is transparent. Those materials which allow light to pass through them are known as transparent. For example, glass, clear water, the diagram is below. Translucent is those items or those materials which allow light to pass through them partially are known as translucent. For example, wax paper, parchment paper. So when you throw light on them, not the entire light goes through it, okay? So only some part of the light passes through that particular thing. Next one is opaque objects. Those materials which do not allow light to pass through them are known as opaque. So for example, black paint, brick, wood, okay? So if you have a brick wall, okay, if you're putting a torch on it, you will not find any light passing through it. On the other side, you will not see any light. So that is transparency. Moving on, electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity could be understood with the help of conductors and insulators. So what are conductors? The materials which allow heat and electricity to pass through them are called conductors. Metallic wire are good conductors of electricity, hence they are used for electrical supply. Copper and silver are also examples of good conductors of heat and electricity. So when you touch a copper wire, and on the other end, if there is heat, you will feel the heat in your hand also. While on the other hand, we have insulators. An insulator is a material that does not conduct electrical current or heat. Insulating materials include paper, plastic, rubber, glass, and air. So these are the items which do not pass the electricity or the heat. Okay. So if you are sitting in a room or if you are cooking, in fact, okay, and you are using a rubber handle on your steel spoon, okay, you will not feel the heat, okay, until unless the food enters your mouth. So that's example of electrical conductivity. Moving on, solubility is of 3 types. We are talking about sugar water solution, where if you mix the sugar into water, it mixes completely. We have oil water solution, where if you mix the oil with water, the oil, because it is less dense than water, okay, so it will be on the upper side and the water will be on the lower side, as you see in this diagram in the middle. Then we have sand water solution. Sand water solution will never mix completely. You will find that the sand settles at the bottom of the glass. So that is solubility. Moving on, luster. So, luster, we have 2 spellings, so both are correct. We can also call them lustrous. Okay, so luster is the way light interacts with the surface of a crystal, rock or mineral. So for example, silver, if you see silver has shine, but sulfur does not have any shine. So a lot of items do not have shine. Okay, a lot of items which have shine, they are called lustrous items. Items which do not have any shine are called non-lustrous. Next and the last one is living and non-living. We will have an entire chapter on this. Living things are those which are able to move on their own and breathe, while non-living things are those which do not breathe and are unable to move on their own. So if you see the examples here, okay, so a boy is there, flowers are there, butterfly is there, dog is there, tree is there, plant is there. These are living things. Non-living things are your books, your metallic objects, your glasses, flasks, your clothes, the globe, the pencil holder. So these items do not move, they do not breathe, so hence they are called non-living thing. So that would be it. Okay, what do you need to remember for this chapter are the groups on the basis of their property, the same table that we discussed in the beginning. If you remember this, it would be easier for you to understand and remember the entire chapter at all. Okay, because this will give you a gist of what we discussed in the entire chapter. So if you have any question, you can WhatsApp me on my personal number, which we have already shared. Or you can also mail me at prakash.dvd@gmail.com. This would be end of chapter 4. Next week, we are going to discuss chapter 5. So this is the end of sorting materials into groups. Thank you everyone for joining. Have a nice day. Bye.